Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Wooly. Today I am going to show you guys how to add a cookie policy feature to your WooCommerce store. In this tutorial, we will use a free WordPress plugin to get this done for us. Do you know how important it is to add a cookie policy feature to your online store, right? It's because adding this feature to your online store will help you track the user's data to create a better user experience. And the cookie law is a piece of privacy legislation that you need to obtain consent from your site visitors. Before we get started, I want to welcome back all my subscribers. I appreciate you all. But for those who are brand new to my channel, my name is Wooly. I create tutorials about e-commerce web designs, focusing on user experience using WordPress. All right, with that being said, let's jump right in. All right, let's go to our demo store. Scroll down a little bit to click plugins. We are going to install a GDPR plugin. Go to the search box and type GDPR cookie consent. And that's the plugin we will install. It is made by WebToffee. It has over 1 million active installations and the ratings are over 1,000 ratings. That is pretty good. Click install now button and then click the activate button and then you will be redirected back to the plugin's main page. Just scroll down to find the GDPR cookie consent plugin so you can enable the button or the link to enable the auto update feature. So the system will update the plugin automatically for you. Next, click on the settings to go to the general settings. The first tab is called general. Just leave the settings on this tab as default, except when you select the type of law, there are a couple options that you could choose. In this tutorial, I will select the last option, which is for CCPA and GDPR. It is to comply with both the laws on the same website if your target audience from European Union and California. Make sure you check enable CCPA and show CCPA notice is checked too. And then just click the update settings button. And then let's go to the next tab. Actually, it is another tab inside the general tab. It is called other. Usually we just leave all the options here alone. By default, reload after scroll accept event, just always no. After it's done, just click the update settings button. And then let's go to the next tab, which is customize cookie bar. The first sub tab is cookie bar. You could see the message in the box right there. It has a lot of HTML tags. Just ignore them. All the text inside the angle brackets, just ignore them. That is the text that I just highlighted that you can modify a little bit, but don't have to modify that much. If you don't want to, just leave this box alone and then it will be okay. Next, you can go to the cookie bar color right there. I need to go grab a custom color from the front end of the store by using a Google Chrome color picker. Whatever color you want to change your cookie bar to look like, make sure all the colors would be matching with your color palettes to go with the branding of your website or your online store. scroll down a little bit more, and you can leave the rest of the options alone, like show cookie bar as pop-up. Once everything looks good, just click the update settings button. And next, for the under sub tab, this for revisit consent, there are many positions that you could pick from. As of right now, I will select the bottom right, and from the right margin of your website, that is the pixels, just leave it alone, and then text on the widget, I just change it a little bit, and then just click the update settings when it looks good to you. And the next tab, it is customize buttons. For the first tab, for the first sub tab, for this one, it is for the accept all button. The text right here, you could change the text here to something else, but I would say just leave it alone for now. I need to grab another color from the front end of the store, of the demo store. And I'm gonna change this color to the green of the demo store box. And then you just could pick whatever you want here. After you are done, just click the update settings button. I just stick with the medium size for now. Once everything looks good, just click the update settings button on the bottom right. The next sub tab is the accept button. Mostly right here, you can leave all the default settings alone. It looks fine too, but don't forget to change the background color. That is the color of the button. So I need to grab some of the colors from the demo store to match with my branding colors. I'm going to use my Google Chrome color picker to pick out some of the colors from the demo store. So I'm gonna pick out the blue color and grab the hex code and paste it right here. As for the action box, just leave it alone and then just click the update settings button. The next sub tab is the reject button. I'm gonna change the background color of the button here to orange color to match with the demo store color palettes. And then I just leave the rest of the settings alone and click the update settings button. The next sub tab is for the settings button. I will just leave the setting alone. It looks fine too. And then just click the update settings button. And let's go to the next sub tab, which is read more. Usually right here, it looks fine too. At the URL or page right there, you can either pick URL or the page. If you pick URL, you have to copy the entire address of URL of the cookie policy page right there. But if you click the page, if you already have your privacy policy page set up, you should be able to find it right there and select that page. And then just leave the rest of the settings the same, and then just click the update settings button once everything looks good. The next sub tab is do not sell. This is for the site visitors who live in California. You can leave show as link the same as the default setting right here. It is fine too. Once everything looks good, just click the update settings button at the bottom right. And we should be done for the settings of the customized buttons. Next, it is the advanced tab. Usually, we just not gonna do anything under this tab, just leave everything the same, just click the update settings button and then we should be good. And the last tab is help guide. This is all the general information that you could read or go through if you want to know a little bit about the cookie bar plugin shortcodes. They are right here under this tab. So if you don't want to pay attention to it, that's fine too. We should be good. And let's go to the menu under the plugin on the left. Let's click on the cookie list. This is the list that will be listed on the cookie bar box when the user clicks the cookie consent tab. And I will show you guys at the end how that box will look like. You can basically click each of them to edit the description on the right there, but you don't want to edit or modify the text that much, except if you really see an obvious typo or something like that. And the next menu is the cookie category. These are the categories that the plugin gives us as a default. So if you want to read through them, that's fine. Otherwise, let's move on to the next tab, which is cookie scanner. Right here, we don't have to worry about it, but if you want to scan your website for cookies, you can sign up an account with cookie scanner right here by clicking the button connect and scan. But in this tutorial, I'm not going to go over that. Let's go to the next menu, which is policy generator. You can use this feature to generate your cookie policy page automatically for you. Basically, the plugin just will insert a new page for you with this description. And let's go to the next menu, which is script blocker. As for this menu, you don't have to worry about this. It is for whatever you want to manage script blocking, like official Facebook pixel, Smashballoon Twitter feed, Smashballoon Instagram feed, or Google Analytics for WordPress by Monster Insights. And the next menu is the privacy overview. You can modify the text in the description box right here a little bit if you want to, but don't modify or change it that much. The default text that they give it to us is quite good already. Once everything looks good, just let's go to the front end and refresh the page. And right there, that's our cookie policy box. And we can click on the Do Not Sell My Personal Information. Since we selected that option for some Californians. And when we click the next link, you can see all the cookie categories that we just looked at in the back end. And you could click on the show list. That's the text, the rest of the text for the privacy overview. And you can also expand each cookie category right here to read more information about it. That you can also edit all this text or information in the back end that I just showed you earlier. Turn on, enable, or disable advertisement or any cookie categories here that you want. Once you're done, just click the Save and Accept button. And then it will stay at the bottom right corner right there. That's pretty much it. That's all for today's tutorial. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys think about adding a cookie policy feature to your online store, and would love to share it with our community. I would love to hear from you guys a lot. Make sure to subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet and turn on that notification bell so you won't miss any future uploads about e-commerce web designs from me. If you guys find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up. I would appreciate your support a lot. Thank you so much. If you guys want to support my channel, I add all the links in the description box below for you guys to check out. Alright, thank you so much for being here to watch my video. You guys have a wonderful day. Wherever you are, I'll see you in my next video. Bye now!